Hello, welcome to the session on direct address mapping technique. This is Dayanand Patil, working as assistant professor in CSE department, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. At the end of this session, you'll be able to explain direct mapping technique and its advantages and disadvantages. So before going to the direct address mapping technique, what is address mapping? So this is the smallest unit of address data that can be mapped independently to an area of virtual address space. In the previous video lecture, we have seen while running an application that particular program is loaded from main memory to cache memory. That we know that cache memory size is less than the main memory size. All the blocks of main memory is mapped into the cache memory. So while mapping that main memory address to the cache memory, so we are using the different techniques. So there are usually three techniques: the direct mapping, associative mapping, and set associative mapping. In this video lecture, we are discussing the direct mapping technique. So before going to discuss technique, we are assuming that the memory size, or considering the example, so we know that the line size of cache memory equal to the block size of main memory. So usually we consider that the block size is 4 words. Yeah, and that 4 word means that 1 word size is 1 byte. So if there are 4 words, so that 4 equal to 2 square. So if we need to identify that particular word in that block, so we are using the 2 bits to identify that particular block in that particular word in the particular block. We have seen this in the previous video. The last 2 least significant bits are used to identify that particular word in that block. That is called as displacement address. Okay, so here we are considering the displacement D. Okay, so that is the least two significant bits. And the cache memory size is assumed 16 words. If there are 16 words, each cache line will be, that size of each cache line is 4 words, then that 16 divided by 4 equal to 4 cache lines. There will be 4 cache lines. So that 4 cache lines can be addressed using 2-bit binary numbers. We are considering that is R equal to 2 bits. We will see in the next slide what is R, what is D in detail. We are taking R equal to 2. And that main memory size is assumed 64 bytes. If there are 64 bytes, that 64 bytes can be, that 64 equal 2 raised to 6. So if there are 64 bytes, means there will be 64 words in the main memory. If we need to uniquely identify those 64 bytes, then we need, that is 64 equal to 2 raised to 6 means that total address length of the main memory is 66 bits. If it is 6 bits, the 2 least significant bits are used to identify the word, and remaining 4 MSB bits identifies that particular block in the main memory. The total number of block in main memory is that if it is 64 bytes, then each block will be containing 4 bytes, that is 4 word. So that is total number of blocks in main memory is 64 divided by 4 equal to 16. Here we can see how that direct mapping will take place. So here we can see, so these are the cache lines 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, and totally there are 64 memory words as we have assumed in the previous example. So there are 64 words, and which block of the main memory is placed to which cache line, that is mapping technique. The mapping technique means which block of main memory will be mapped to which of the cache lines in a cache memory. So in direct mapping technique, those blocks from main memory are mapped in round robin manner. Here you can see there are only 4 cache lines, 0, 1, 2, 3, 2, 4. But there are totally 64 memory words in a main memory. So first 0 is mapped to 0th line of cache. First memory word is mapped to first line. Second is mapped to second cache line. Third block to third cache line. Once we reach that third cache line, we'll go next block of main memory will be mapped to the again 0th line. So fifth will be 2-1. So in a round robin manner, from 0 to 3, again 4 to 7 and 8 to 11. So in this manner, those main memory blocks are mapped to cache lines in a direct mapping technique. So 0, 4, 8, 12 are mapped to 0th line, 15913 are mapped to first line, so on. So here we can see one thing: if 0 is already existed in the cache memory, if the process need to access the 8th, 12th or 4th, okay, so it will override the 0th line only, because even if the 1, 2, 3 are free, it cannot use, because that particular block of main memory will be that copied into that particular cache line only. So this is in a round robin manner. So here we can see, so in the last two, that totally, that for the previous example, for this one, okay, total length of the address is 6 bit. So the two least significant bits are used to identify that particular word in that particular block, that is displacement, and these remaining four, these are representing that most significant bit. So this, if there are totally 16 blocks in main memory, so that 0 to 15 blocks. So these, the four MSB bits will identify the block number. Again, in direct mapping technique, the next two bits, okay, that is R bits. The R, if it is, the size is 4 lines, it is R equal to 2. If it is 4 bytes or 4 words, then R equal to 3. It depends upon the memory size. So the next R bits are used to identify that particular cache line. So here we can see there are totally 0 to 16 blocks. So this is 0, 1, 2, 3 in a, that binary number. So the last two bits will be used to identify the cache line. Here we can see that 0th block from the main memory is mapped to 0th line of the cache. Okay, the first block of main memory is mapped to the first line of the cache. The second one is mapped to second. Third one is mapped to the third line. Again, next the fourth one will come. The fourth block of the main memory is mapped to the 0th line again. The fifth is mapped to the first line. Sixth is mapped to second line, so on. So in this one, so these are mapped in this way. The next, so in this way, so the last two bits are used as the least significant bit are used to identify that displacement address. The R bits are used, that is two for this example, two bits are used to identify that block should be matched to which cache line. And the last two bits in this example are used to identify which block is present in that cache line, whether 0 is present, 4 is present or 8 present. So last two bits are used to recognize that which block is present in that particular line of the cache. So this is the format for this example: the two bits for the tag, two bits for the line, and two bits for the displacement. Here we can see the direct mapping. This is the memory size. There are from 0 to 15, and these are the words. 0th line contains 0, 1, 2, 3 memory words. The next line, next block containing 4, 5, 6, 7, and so on. There are 0 to 16 blocks, each block containing 4 memory words from 0 to 63. So these are mapped into the cache. Okay. So first one is mapped to 0. Next, second one is mapped to next line. Third one, fourth one. So it is in round robin fashion. So on, that 8th and 12th will be mapped to 0, like that previous side, in the previous slide we have seen here, the 0, 4, 8, 12. So here we have seen. So likewise, so in this slide, these are mapped at in the round robin fashion. Okay, so it will continue, so on. This is time to reflect. Now pause the video and answer for the question. That question is, the cache size is 64 bytes, main memory size is 16 bytes, and block size is 4 word. We need to calculate that address mapping fields, length of the address mapping fields. The block size is 4 means that displacement is d equal to 2 bits. And main memory size is 16 megabytes. So that 16 mega means that 2 raised to 24. So total length of the address is 24 bits. In that 24 bits, cache size is 64 kilobytes. That 64 kilo means 2 raised to 14. So R equal to 14. That R field is 14 bits in this example. So that S equal to total length minus R. That 24 minus, sorry, that 24 minus 2 is the displacement. The remaining bit is 22. 22 minus R is, that R is 14, so S equal to 8 bit. So for this example, that tag field is 8 bit, that S equal to A, that S minus R equal to 8 bit, line size, that R equal to 14 bits, and displacement D equal to 2 bits. The advantages and disadvantages, here we can see it is easy to implement because it does not require any searching technique to search a block in cache, because we know if we need to search that 8th block, whether it is present in the cache, it will directly go to the 0th cache line and it will search for it, because that always that 8th block of main memory will be mapped to the 0th line of cache only. So that is in round robin fashion, we know already. So it will directly go to that particular cache line and it will find that block whether it is present or not. And the disadvantage is that fixed cache location for any given block, because so we need to the map that 0th, 4th and so on, these blocks to the that 0th line of the cache memory only. Even if there is the cache line, next cache line, first, second, third cache lines are free, we cannot map that 8th block of main memory to the 0th line of the cache. So here we are not utilizing the cache memory fully. So this is the disadvantage of the direct mapping technique. There are references I have used. Thank you.